The skies above Europe are becoming increasingly congested, as are Europe's major airports. This growth in air traffic means smaller airports also need to be safely accessible at all times, which cannot be achieved by relying solely on non-precision approaches. However, precision approaches require a substantial investment in ground-based navigational aids. But not anymore. EGNOS, the European Geostationary Navigation Overlay Service, offers enhanced vertical as well as horizontal precision and integrity, improving safety, accessibility, and efficiency for operators, pilots, and airports across Europe. EGNOS is a satellite-based augmentation system that improves GNSS positioning using three satellites and a network of more than 39 reference stations in 24 countries, providing much greater accuracy than achieved through GPS alone. Here's how it works. Stations on the ground pick up signals from GPS satellites, which are then centrally processed. The accuracy of the original signals is determined, and factors such as ionospheric disturbances are taken into account. These data are incorporated into EGNOS correction signals and sent to its three geostationary satellites. The satellites then relay the signals back to users. The result is substantially improved horizontal and vertical positioning accuracy and data integrity. But how can EGNOS make a difference? EGNOS improves safety by providing pilots with accurate vertical guidance, increasing situational awareness, and reducing workload.
Unlike old GPS approaches, which gave you only lateral guidance, the new approaches give you both a vertical as well as lateral guidance.
If you can improve the safety of one of the most critical phases of flight, being the approach, you basically improve overall flight safety.
EGNOS can also act as a backup for ground-based systems and is a key element of the future of air traffic management. EGNOS will be pivotal to provide reliable positioning for ADS-B. This is a new cooperative surveillance technology in which an aircraft determines its location using GNSS and periodically broadcasts it, enabling it to be tracked.
EGNOS is a key portion of the ADS-B out technology and is going to allow more accurate transponder technology, more accurate air traffic control management, more accurate point-to-point positioning of aeroplanes for traffic avoidance.
There is, in my mind, no doubt about it that EGNOS is really a major safety enabler in aviation.
EGNOS can be a cost-effective alternative to ILS CAT-1, offering similar performance without the need for costly ground-based infrastructure and maintenance.
The ELPV approach allows us to make ILS look-alike approaches with the same minimas, allowing the same service to the passengers, but without the ground-based aids.
With the EGNOS procedure, at a very low cost, we can optimize the operations on the runway.
The lower decision heights enabled by EGNOS can also reduce costly delays, diversions, and cancellations.
We started off with the basic LNAV approach, and that minimum was 500 feet, so that's the lowest a pilot could fly before he had to initiate a missed approach. An LPV using EGNOS brings it down to 250 to 300 feet here, so the aircraft can be a lot lower before it has to initiate a missed approach.
All that's needed is an onboard EGNOS certified receiver, an adapted procedure for the runway end, and an adapted flight management system. For pilots, flying EGNOS approaches only requires limited training and will in many cases be smoother than using an ILS.
Once you practice it and you perform it, it's quite simple. You feel that flight path is smoother and the maneuvers are smoother than flying an ILS.
With an EGNOS procedure, even small and medium-sized airports and heliports remain accessible, even in poor weather conditions.
Today we're being funneled to hubs and major airports. Tomorrow, with EGNOS and with LPVs, we would be able to fly to all the airfields and aerodromes and regional airports in Europe.
For this kind of runway or airports who do not have an ILS today, you increase the accessibility because of the good performance of EGNOS.
The helicopter receives more precise data, which improves positioning accuracy and reliability. This means we can fly closer to the ground safely.
EGNOS can also reduce the impact of aviation on the environment by facilitating curved approaches and continuous descent paths, and therefore reduce both noise and emissions.
We do continuous descents, so we end up with a lower noise print, we end up with less carbon emissions and a better fuel economy.
For helicopters, EGNOS allows custom approach procedures to be developed from any direction using steeper approaches than those flown by fixed-wing aircraft, thereby avoiding densely populated areas. EGNOS was certified for civil aviation in 2011. Hundreds of EGNOS procedures have been published, and many more are under development at airports across Europe. The majority of navigation systems in today's aircraft and helicopters now integrate EGNOS.
I don't think we've sold a receiver for the last 7 years that didn't include EGNOS capability.
Furthermore, EGNOS is still improving. EGNOS version 3, which will integrate Galileo, is under development, and EGNOS will be extended across and possibly beyond Europe. EGNOS can provide accessibility, safety, and cost savings in a single proven solution by delivering high precision with low investment.